NASA is well known for its space exploration and discoveries. However, the agency is also researching the Earth, right here on the planet. One such example is a startling new find beneath Antarctica's ice that has changed scientists' perceptions of the Earth. What exactly has NASA discovered? Is it affecting you? It makes sense that not many individuals consider traveling to Antarctica to be their ideal vacation. Antarctica is the fifth largest continent with a total area of 14 million square kilometers, or 5.4 million square miles. The extent of the sea ice along the coast expands over the winter, approximately doubling the continent's area. Less than 5% of the vast wilderness in Antarctica is ice-free, and most of the continent is covered in ice. In a region under 1.5 times the size of the United States, this place is home to 90% of all the ice on Earth. The air is so cold that if you toss boiling water into the air, most of the particles will change into steam. At the same time, the remainder will rapidly transform into little bits of ice. As a result, the water will instantly evaporate. East and West Antarctica are the two regions of the continent. East Antarctica is roughly the size of Australia and makes up approximately two-thirds of the continent. The ice in this section of the continent is 1.2 miles or 2 kilometers thick on average. West Antarctica is a chain of ice islands going towards South America's southern edge, extending the Andes Mountains. The Transantarctic Mountains, which span the continent and are occasionally entirely covered in ice, divide the two zones. Is plant life present in Antarctica? In a way. It consists of only a few mosses, lichens, and algae. Seasonal moss cover in Antarctica has steadily risen over the previous 50 years. Despite the lack of amphibians, reptiles, and terrestrial mammals, animal life is far more plentiful. During the summer, large populations of penguins, whales, fish, and invertebrates thrive along Antarctica's coast and frigid seas. What about human life on this vast ice sheet? There are no indigenous people in Antarctica due to the harsh weather. Up to 4,000 visiting scientists can be found across 70 research stations in the summer, braving the cold on the continent. During the more brutal winters, that number drops to 1,000. Antarctica is primarily a research destination for climatologists, oceanographers, and marine biologists. However, the frozen desert also draws astronomers from all over the world. This is because Antarctica is one of the best places on Earth for astronomical observation, if you can stand the cold. This is due to its dry climate and lack of light pollution. When it comes to watching space, NASA, the king of the outer universe, is involved. What exactly has NASA been up to in Antarctica? Looking down from above, the Antarctic ice sheet may appear to be a calm, perpetual ice blanket covering Antarctica for millions of years. But don't be surprised if the ice sheet is thousands of meters thick, at its thickest point, and conceals hundreds of meltwater lakes where its base meets the continent's bedrock. Scientists have improved their maps of these hidden lake systems beneath the West Antarctic ice sheet using the most advanced Earth-observing laser instrument NASA has ever flown in space, and have discovered two more of these active subglacial lakes named Conway and Mercer. The new research is critical for detecting fresh subglacial lakes from space and determining how this hidden plumbing system influences the rate at which ice melts into the Southern Ocean. Adding fresh water may alter its circulation and ecosystems. With NASA's ICE, Cloud and Land Elevation Satellite 2, or ICESat 2, scientists have been able to map the subglacial lakes precisely. The satellite measures of the ice surface, which rises or falls despite its enormous thickness as lakes fill or empty under the ice sheet. The study, published in Geophysical Research Letters, integrates height data from ICESat 2's predecessor, the original ICESat mission, and the European Space Agency satellite dedicated to monitoring polar ice thickness, CryoSat 2. The hydrology systems beneath the Antarctic ice sheet have been a mystery for decades. This began to change in 2007 when Helen Amanda Fricker, a glaciologist at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography at the University of California, San Diego, she made a breakthrough that helped update the classical understanding of Antarctic subglacial lakes. Using data from the original ICESat in 2007, Fricker found that under Antarctica's fast-flowing ice streams for the first time, an entire network of lakes connects, filling and draining actively over time. Before, these lakes were thought to hold meltwater statically, without filling and emptying. The original ISAT mission is credited with discovering the interconnected systems of lakes at the ice-bed interface that are moving water around, allowing scientists to study all the impacts on glaciology, microbiology, and oceanography. However, with ISAT 2, scientists had a powerful tool that yielded data so high in precision that they could start mapping out the lake boundaries on the surface. Scientists have hypothesized subglacial water exchange in Antarctica results from a combination of factors, including fluctuations in the pressure exerted by a massive weight of the ice above, the friction between the bed of the ice sheet and the rocks beneath, and heat coming up from the earth below that is insulated by the thickness of the ice. This is in stark contrast to the Greenland ice sheet, where lakes at the ice bed fill with meltwater that has drained through surface cracks and holes. How deep do the Conway and Mercer lakes go beneath the surface? These gems of frigid water are beneath 1.2 to 2.5 miles or 2.4 to 4 kilometers of ice on the southernmost continent. They fill and drain over and over in largely mysterious cycles that may influence how fast the ice sheet moves and how and where meltwater reaches the Southern Ocean. This flow, in turn, can change the currents in the Southern Ocean and potentially affect ocean circulation worldwide. Unlike most lakes on the surface, which remain in the exact location for years, this underground water system is dynamic or highly fluid, pun intended. Scientists could trace changes in a subglacial lake system between 2003 and 2020 by combining data from multiple satellites. They concentrated their efforts on three areas with good satellite coverage and known active lakes: the Mercer and Williams ice streams in West Antarctica, the Lower MacAyill ice stream in West Antarctica, and the Upper Academy Glacier in East Antarctica. At the Mercer and Williams boundaries, the researchers found two new lakes, which they dubbed the Lower Conway Subglacial Lake and the Lower Mercer Subglacial Lake. They also found that what was thought to be one lake under the MacAyill ice stream was two. These lakes have changed dramatically over time. For example, the lakes beneath the Mercer and Williams ice stream boundaries have undergone at least three periods of drainage in 17 years. Meanwhile, all the lakes beneath the MacAyill ice stream have followed their patterns of draining and filling. The lowermost lake went through four fill drain events during the study period, each taking only a year to complete. The second lake drained between 2014 and 2015 and filled up again, while the third drained slightly between 2016 and 2017. Meanwhile, the lakes beneath Academy Glacier drained between 2009 and 2018. These changes are puzzle pieces in scientists' understanding of the speed and direction of Antarctica's ice sheet flow. Already, researchers are finding links between the under-ice lakes and the ocean. In January last year, a study I co-authored found that the drainage of one lake on the Amory Ice Shelf in East Antarctica flushed as much as 198 billion gallons, or 750 billion liters, into the ocean in only 3 days, as reported by Live Science. While finding lakes buried deep underneath the ice in the Antarctic is fascinating, one question you might be asking is whether there is life in that lake. The environment is harsh enough on the surface, but can life survive deep within the two newly discovered lakes? Early investigations of Lake Mercer water samples revealed that they had around 10,000 bacterial cells per millimeter. According to expedition leader John Priskew, a professor of Arctic ecology at the University of Montana. At the same time, this represents just about 1% of the 1 million microbial cells per millimeter seen in the open ocean. It is a stunning find for a sunless body of water buried deep beneath an Antarctic glacier. However, the high levels of bacterial life in a dark and profoundly underground lake indicate that it may host higher life forms, such as tiny creatures like tardigrades. Meanwhile, the abundance of bacterial life in Lake Mercer mirrored the discovery of high levels of bacterial life in Antarctica's adjacent subglacial Lake Williams in 2013, during an expedition also headed by Priskew. The bacteria in Lake Williams and probably Lake Mercer are thought to be thriving on carbon deposits set down by photosynthesizing species between 5,000 and 10,000 years ago, when the submerged lakes were linked to the open ocean. During their stay on the ice from mid-December last year, the expedition team used drills and hot water to open a borehole from their camp at the frozen surface to the buried lake of liquid water. The drill team bore through about 3,504 feet or 1,068 meters of ice. The water below was 30.8 degrees Fahrenheit or minus 0.65 degrees Celsius, allowing scientists to collect water samples and sediment cores from the lake, which was about 49 feet or 15 meters deep at the time. The crew had also dropped a sophisticated remotely operated underwater vehicle or ROV into the murky waters of the submerged lake. They also used numerous cameras to photograph and film the lake floor. The discovery has ramifications for the hunt for life on the other worlds, notably Mars. The data from the European Space Agency's Orbiting Mars Express probe revealed evidence of a subsurface lake of liquid salt water in 2018. Prisco believes that any life beneath Mars' icy surface may mimic the patterns found in Antarctica's subglacial lakes. That is our video for today. We hope you like it. What are your thoughts on NASA's strange new discovery under Antarctica's ice? How does the discovery affect studying life on Mars? Share all of your thoughts with us in the comment section below. Well, that's all for now. This is Big Tech Media. See you again tomorrow. Keep in mind to like, share, and subscribe.